You all know very well about it. Now COP 26 is going on from the 31st onwards to 12th to discuss about the climate change. From the Earth Summit, first Earth Summit onwards, there's so much of the discussions to control the environmental conditions, environmental pollutions, climate change, to preserve, to conserve our nature, to go back to our nature, to maintain the balance, sustainability in the ecosystem. Next, please, sir. Can I? Yeah. Yeah. You know, from our ancient onwards, the Vedas onwards, we are actually we feel proud of our Indians. We from our old traditions, we having the plenty of the knowledge about the nature and science and technology. One more small request: all the people, the delegates, are talked about the acts and their effects. So I am giving just a general talk upon it, just to give to an idea. Okay, that you say here and says are that the prakriti, this prakriti of man is divided 8-fold. That's earth, water, fire, air, space, mind, intellect, and also egoism. You know the panchabhutas. We always pray for the panchabhutas. You know, every function, festival, rituals, traditions, we follow these ecological activities, ecosystem activities. You know, the bhumir apo nalo vayu kama, there is something kama mano buddhir eva kha khara aitihami bhumi prakriti asthada. Like that, environment, you know, the survival, environment is required for the survival of human being, not only human being, for all the living beings. You know, the biodiversity, variability among the living organisms, all type of the living organisms which are there on the earth, that need the external and internal aspects. You know, the external aspects are panchabhutas, and internal aspects are our internal things. The next slide, please, sir. You know, on our Vedas time also, we having the given importance to the earth. We call it as mother earth. Mother earth, bestow love on a creature living on it. Matha bhumi putroha putrivaha. Oh, mother. Like that. Next slide, please. We have given so much of the importance to control the pollution. You know, the we have given the very much important to the nature, prakriti. We always, our Indians worship the sun and plants, so some of the animals. You know the sloka in the Rigveda, dashakupa sama vapi, dashavapi samahrada, dashaharda sama putro, dashaputra sama drumaha. You know, the one pond equal to 10 wells, and a reservoir equal to 10 ponds, one sun equal to 10 reservoirs, but one tree equal to 10 suns. They have what much importance they have given to the nature to conserve. So we should know about our tradition, nature, before knowing about the climate change effect. Even in the COP 26, the first time, this time, our Minister of Environment, Forest, also started the discussion with the Sanskrit sloka. First time in our Indian discuss the Sanskrit sloka explanations, the olden times, how we are. With that, they started in this environmental program, convention. That is a priority. We should go back to our science, past back science, to conclude, to preserve, to conserve, to overcome from the climate change. How we have to, what we have to, where, on what way we can. Yeah, so next slide, please, sir. Yeah, here, there, we have plenty of the source to conserve the nature. The biodiversity, each and every, one thing, in the planet, you know, the only one planet to live, that is the Earth. We call it as Mata Bhumi, Bhumata, Mother Earth. That having the plenty of the biodiversity, that biodiversity, each and every living organism, the biota, having the importance. Each and every organism, there is no waste plant, there is no waste animal on the planet. you know, what you call it is a pichimokka, waste plant, weed plant, but also having the most valuable one. You know, the whatever the hairs, some of the hairs, suppose Indigopera tinctoria, that very highly valuable indelible ink that prepared from the small herb, which we neglected. You know, the grasses, we felt it is a waste. But, you know, the grass that release the fresh oxygen, because the grass epidermis layer, it having the silicon dioxide. That silicon dioxide will release the fresh oxygen, silica and oxygen. So that give the fresh oxygen so that our mind will be fresh up. We will wake up. We will know that awareness, awakening of our brain. Like that, each and every organism, you know, the simple single fungi, yeast, you know, the Saccharomyces cerevisiae. That single yeast making us survive with the bakery items and beverages. You know, without the yeast, there is no bakery. Bakery people will be bekar. No bread, no cake, puff, all the things. And no beverages without the fermentation. You know, that there is no beverages. Beer, brand, whiskey, wine, alcohol. You know, these all the technology also our olden days people are used, but they are not destructive. But what we are doing is we are very much using extinctly that causing for the extinction of the biodiversity. You know, we having the so much of the benefits about the biodiversity. You know, the plants only that release the oxygen already, Tulsirao sir said, because of the photosynthesis. If there is no photosynthesis, we can't get the oxygen. That oxygen, we are able to survive with that oxygen only. Otherwise, we have to carry the oxygen cylinders on our back. You know, the corona time, someone died because of the lack of the oxygen cylinder. So like that, in daily life also, we may have to carry the oxygen cylinder. If we can't conserve, we can't save our nature. If we can't survive, we can't know, we don't know about the nature. If we are not having the awareness about the plant's importance, if we cut all the trees, if we do the deforestation, if it calls for the destruction of the plant, we all have to carry the oxygen cylinders or bag. That's what we are getting freely without expending the single NP of the money because of the plants. Because of that plant. That's why our olden people also given more and more importance to the plants. So we also have to give the importance to conserve the nature, to know, to make aware, to prepare, to give it to the future generations. What we are getting now, that also must be the right to enjoy with this nature. Okay, next please, sir. So we can protect our nature. We can conserve our, you know, our olden tradition, our olden people, our grandparents, they are mingled with the cattle, animals. Now we are totally mechanized. Whatever the agriculture also we are doing with the mechanized. You know, the trees, so many trees, they feel it as a sacred one, like a god. Vepa, Tulasi, Aswadha, people, so many trees, they feel like it is a god. Why? Not without knowing of the knowledge, they're having the plenty of the knowledge of the plant, what they give, what they provide, what it is providing to us, how we are surviving with that, that all they know. But our new technology, new trend people, because of the westernization, we are neglecting our Indian culture, we are totally losing our olden tradition, we are totally getting damage of our own environment. As an environment lover, as an ancient environmentalist of Indian, we are totally forgetting about our nature habitat, we are making aware from the unknown people of the Western countries. They are making aware from us, but now they are making aware us. Now what's going on? It is the reverse. We have to make, we the leaders, to make aware about the nature as an Indian, as a traditional Indian. But what happening? You know, we having the plenty of the highly medicinal plants, but instead of that, our peoples in the social forestry, whatever the forestry, roadside avenue forestry, they are planting the waste plants and damaging plants, highly polluted plants. That's very bad situation. Tulsi Rao sir is there. I can't say like that. Sorry, but it is the situation is going on. The Alstonia scholar is Edakula Pala. Instead of our neem, our Ashoka, our so many medicinal plants are there. Instead of that, Edakula Pala that give the bad odor at the flowering season, that cause so many respiratory and even so many disorders also. We can't cut the flowers at the flowering season, all the avenue trees. Instead of that very highly valuable herbal doctor, neem is there. So many plants, aswadha plants are there, and so many pogoda, so many plants are there. But we are neglecting our tradition, we are neglecting our plants. Instead of that, we are encouraging invasive, invading species, exotic species. You know, there's so many exotic species that causing extinction of the rich biodiversity, our rich biodiversity, that we will discuss in the next. Okay, you having a next slide, please, sir. Sir, next slide, please. You know that our India is one of the 17 mega biodiversity country. We having the rich, plenty of the resources, various sources of the 91,000 above species of the animals, 46,000 above species of the plants. We having the plenty of various geographical regions, topographical regions, climatic conditions. Because of that, we feel proud of it. We having the plenty of the biodiversity. We have the rich biodiversity. We the one of the 17 mega biodiversity countries of the world, total 192 countries. We are one of the 17 countries. Before that, only 12 mega biodiversity countries are there. Recently, five mega biodiversity countries added. You know, Australia, Brazil, China, Colombia, Republic Congo recently added. Ecuador, India, Indonesia, Madagascar, Malaysia, Mexico, New Guinea also recently added. Peru, Philippines, South Africa, Venezuela, these also recently added. These 17 mega biodiversity countries, they're having the rich biodiversity, they have the variety of the biodiversity, rich biodiversity. These are all the areas we need to conserve. Because of the poor and because of the unknowing, the lot of the biodiversity is losing. Because of the poverty, because of the poorness, because of the unknowing, we are losing so much of the biodiversity. Whatever the highly medicinal biodiversity of fungus, mushrooms, that being tapped by illiterate people that is carrying forward to China. They are preparing the medicines from that mushroom. You know the palace in our local, we call it as Uppalamma, that give the bad odor at the ripening time. That fungus that earning $360 billion to our India, each single fungi, single mushroom. Like that Ganoderma also caused to being earned $1 billion of the money, single species. Like that, so many plenty, highly rich value biodiversity there in our India. We have to explore it. We have to know, make about it, aware about it. By that, we automatically will conserve. One thing is, we are not making aware about it. We are going to the technology side. We are forgetting the nature. We are forgetting the environment. We are totally molded to system, software, technology. Though we needed the technology, system, software, but we need primarily the nature, knowing about the nature, knowing about the environment. That is most important. You know, the next slide, please, sir. You know, our India having the most different biogeographical topographical areas. We have the 10 biogeographical areas. You know, our India also recognized one of the 8 Wavilolian centers. That means origin of the diversity. So many croplands are originated from our India. Origin from our India. So many croplands. You know, the paddy, what we are now, because of the Green Revolution, we lost so much of the varieties of the our golden gene bank, seed bank, we lost. But olden days, before the Green Revolution, we having the 20,000 varieties of the paddy varieties. But now, because of the hybridization, because of the Green Revolution, Norman Borlaug, our Swaminathan, they are meant for the best cost for the production of the high amount of the food. But now it is totally getting damaged, our environment, our ecosystem, our total, our soil will become from fertile to sessile. It become the total sessile because of the high usage of the fertilizer, high usage of the pesticides, without needing of it. You know, our soil having the plenty of the microbes, mycorrhiza, bacteria, that supply the nutrient which needed to the plant. There is always symbiotism is there between the plant and soil. They can get the nutrition, but because of the industrialization, because of the because of that, we losing our soil fertility. Our soil, especially Indian soil, having the millions of the microbes that are eco-friendly. That all we are losing because of the Green Revolution, because of the more usage of the fertilizers and pesticides, because of the BT, we losing our diversity, our gene bank, our seed bank. You know, we have the more than 300 wild ancestors of close relatives of the cultivated plants. You know, our banana, paddy, wheat, and brinjal, mango, coconut. These are our ancestors, our origins. It's the next place, sir. That's what I told you. There's so many plenty of the microorganisms are there in the soil. That is making our soil become fertile. They are eco-friendly. They are giving all the nutrients which are needed to the plant, They are supply. They having the supply chain to supply the nutrients to the plant. So only one thing is we have to go back to nature, and we need not to discuss more about how to do like that. Just one thing is you have to go back. What our olden people have done. If we do that, we the leaders, we the first people to save the nature, to conserve the nature, to preserve the nature, to draw back the carbon level in the our environment. Next, please, sir. You know, what the plants do, it cover the stability of the, it give the stability of the soil and prevent the land erosion. That's why our ancestors given the importance to the plants. You see, enhance the land's capacity to store the water, stop the erosion, soil erosion. So moderate air, soil, and air and soil temperature also will be moderated with the plants. Help repair climate cycle with the plants. Reduce drought and floods. You know, the supports biodiversity, which are plants and animals which are there in that habitat, and draws down the carbon level. What we are discussing, we have to drop down the carbon dioxide level. But we are increasing the industries. We are going releasing the emissions, wastages, pollutants into the rivers and air without any thinking of it. Though we having the pollution control board, so many acts are there, pollution act, water act, air act, so many acts are there. But what it is doing? Nothing. This all totally molded to high level people. They can maintain with the money, not with the common people. If they follow the common people, if they know the environment, our Indian constitution, if we follow strictly our Indian constitution, we having the, all the rules and controls, conservation acts, all the acts are there, so that we can easily can save, can conserve best before all the countries, of course. But our, sorry to say, our constitution is totally being misplaced, misused by so-called people. That is sorry to say. That give the, our ecotourism culture. You know, next please, sir. I already told you the plant-soil interaction is there. That we are breaking by using the fertilizers and pesticides. You know, have you ever seen the bhoomi picture? Because of the fertilizers and pesticides, we are losing our total fertile soil, will become the sessile, unfertile soil, wasteland, barren land. Olden days, what we have done? We use the decomposed materials, green, what we call it as? Biofertilizers and pachi rotta and excretory materials of the animals that we decompose and we spread in the early season of the in the fields. That what all the world will be following. Now it is following. That is our old ancient method. What we have done. That being so being teach by others. Now we are following the organic cultivation. That is our olden days. That is there before Green Revolution in our India. We totally spoiled because of the Green Revolution. But now again, we are telling about the organic revolution. Organic revolution. With that, we can survive. We can make survive our microorganisms which are there, which do helpful to the plants and all the living biota. You know, the we having the 78% of the nitrogen in the atmosphere. Can any animal use that 78% of the nitrogen? No. Why? Any ammonia, urea makers, they are preparing from the atmospheric nitrogen? No. Only microorganisms, only microbes which are there in the soil, you know, the rhizobacterium and mycorrhiza, the fungus, bacteria, only can take, absorb the atmospheric nitrogen of 78% and it making convert into ammonia, whatever we are using, ammonia and nitrates. That is the usage of the living beings, biodiversity, which are doing naturally. Only thing is we don't disturb that natural biodiversity. That's enough. We are totally destructed. We totally destroyed. Now we are talking about the conservation. We are talking about the climate change. We are talking about the control, drawdown of the carbon dioxide. How it is possible? By cutting all the forests, by cutting the trees. How? You know, the carbon dioxide, it is a misery. Pishinal. It absorbs the more and more heat and it can't release out. So automatically our atmosphere temperature will increase. That cause the global warming, you know. That these all the common people also know. But we only know, we technology people only know the Green Revolution, global warming. No, you don't know. Even Nobel laureates also, they don't know, I think, about that. What our tradition people know. Only thing we have to follow. Even so many Nobel laureates, they said, Einstein also said, the single sentence of Shloka to invent this. But we neglect our olden tradition, our olden culture, olden ancient literature. Sorry to say. Next, please. We have plenty of the benefits with the soil biodiversity. What the soil biota is there, the fungi, microbes, mycorrhiza, algae, bacteria, this all doing help to the health. It become make healthy soil. Using in the climate change mitigation and adaptations, and also in the water purification purpose, and also for the human health and for the plant growth purpose, the soil biota which are there in the soil, that is making preserve, making conserve, making healthy and wealthy, making us healthy and wealthy. That's what we should know, instead of all the things talking about it. What we are getting benefit, if we know the benefit of that, automatically we will conserve. Without knowing of that, intentionally we will conserve it. That's what you should know. That's why I'm discussing it. Sorry, I'm not taking about the now present situation, climate change acts. I just want to make aware about the biodiversity. Okay, you know, the next slide, please. You know the mycorrhiza, how it is, have you seen the roots? That roots having the mycorrhiza, that roots which are there with mycorrhiza, this is associated with the root, having the adjacent network than our telephonic or whatever the internet network. Having the very lengthy network, that's plant having the very lengthy network. This can symbiont, this can make association with the nearby plants, with surrounding plants, which they can interchange the nitrates, ammonia, nutrients, phosphorus, that can supply, interchange, just because of the microbes, mycorrhiza. Do you know? You should know that with that, we don't contaminate. We don't contaminate the soil, if you know that. Only thing is, you should know that what the benefit of that in the soil, natural soil, uncontaminated, unused fertilizers and pesticide soil. You know that network, how much of the network is there? That network is more than our Google, whatever it is, the network. That's having the plants in association with the microbes. That we have to preserve, that we have to conserve. What we are doing is, by using the fertilizers and pesticides, we are damaging the microbiota which are there in the soil. So how the total fertile soil will be become the sessile. The soil fertility is getting damaged. And the automatically CO2 level increase, all the things happen. All the hazards are also released. All the damaging pollutants also release. Temperature also will increase. The next slide, please. Next slide, please, sir. You know the change effect, how the climate change affects. It affects so much. I already discussed our delegates and discussed how it affects the climate change. You know that it causes so much of the disorders to our health. Not only to the plants, all the human beings, all the living beings being affected with the climate change. You know, the raising of the carbon dioxide level, increasing of the temperature, more extreme weather events, and climbing increasing the sea levels. That all cause for the severe weather conditions, weather condition, air pollutions, more allergens, that impact on water quality, so much extreme heat, this all cause for the so many health problems, injuries, mental disorders, asthma, cardio problems, and seasonal diseases like the malaria, dengue, because of climate change. We lost our insect fellers, plants. We are losing our insectivorous plants, like whatever the chrysanthemum, so some plants are there that we are losing because of the invasive species also. You know, the Parthenium that came from the US with the weeds, that now that widely spread in our India everywhere, that is dominating our medicinal herbs, medicinal shrubs and medicinal herbs, which are growing widely, that are being dominated with the Parthenium. You know, the invasive species we have in the other. Okay, and then you know the lantana, lantana species that also widely spread in the forest that is damaging the natural flora which are there in the mountain and hills and the forest, dense forest areas. And you know the Eichhornia that is totally causing the sink of the ponds, lakes. That is the one of the great advantage to the encroachers, to encroach the ponds, rivers, and even lakes. If you spread the Eichhornia, Gurravadekka, within the short span of the time, that pond, lake will be sink and it will be totally filled with the dust and wastages of the Eichhornia. So easily, the lake pond width will be decreased. That area, that decrease, whatever the area encroached by the Eichhornia, now being built apartments, stores of the apartments. In our Hyderabad, before 20 years back, 300 above lakes are there. Now, it might be 30 also not there. That are totally encroaching. That also causing the climate change. What happening? Total streets, total houses also filling with the rainwater. Unseasonal rain, overheating, over temperature, unseasonal rains, unseasonal floods. That is one of the causes of the invasive species. Like that, in, I already told you, Alstonia and Calocarpus. Now they are widely growing the Calocarpus in the roadside. That's a mangrove plant, but it is growing in the roadsides. That also causing the major environment loss to the nearby plant, nearby microbiota, nearby herbs. That we are, and without knowing of that, we are losing our biota by encouraging the outside plants to our India. Without the knowledge, they are planting that instead of our natural environmental eco-friendly plants, they are growing that. Like that invading species, exotic species, and so many migrant species. That all causes, next please. You know about the climate change. Sir, before that slide, please. The social and economic impacts, how it impacting the climate change. Relocating the old towns, what are there? Our village is going to vanish, and cities, towns will be arising. Whatever agriculture lands will be barren because of the real estate. You know, we also allow the development, but we also need the environment to survive. You know, effects that is causing the climate change, our and social and economic impact, how it impacts. So many diseases are causing now. The corona, like the dengue, like there are so many yellow fever, so many that are causing because of the extreme environmental conditions, extreme meteorological phenomenons. Whatever the consumers levels also increase, and the loss of capacity of work also happening now. Our golden people, they could able to do more and more work. They could able to walk more and run more and more kilometers. They can carry the weight up to 50 kgs. But what our tech people, what our nowadays people, what our new generation, they can't carry even 10 kgs to 10 kilometers. They can't run at least 2 kilometers. What is happening? Because of the climate change. Because of the polluted, because of the pesticide, fertilizers usage, crops, because of the unhealthy food, because of the fully loaded biomass of the wastage pesticides, fully accumulation, bioaccumulation of the pesticides and fertilizers. You know, that because of the bioaccumulation of the pesticide and fertilizers, our eagles' owls are totally getting vanished. The eye level accumulation is going on there. You know, our capacity of the power level also decreasing because of the climate change, because of this industrialization, because of this pollutions that are emitting from the does all the things. We lost the fresh water. You know, the 10 years back, we could able to drink water from the river, lakes directly. Just 15 years, 20 years back, before 2000, we could able to drink the water freshly anywhere in the forest, anywhere, even in the small ponds and lakes also. But can you drink directly now? Can't, because it is fully loaded with the pesticides and fertilizers. It is fully loaded with the banned chemicals. That's why our farmers are being died. Well, we all know. Next, please. If you discuss like this, so much of the time it takes. Next slide, please. Okay. You know how the changes occur. Global temperature will increase. That cause for the melting of the ice in the polar regions. That dip the so many coastal cities. That also loss for the so much of the civilization. That also cause loss of the so much of the civilization. We lost so much of the genetic diversity because of the climate change. Already we lost, Tulsirao sir said, 85% of the board, 70% of the things, so many are become extinct, because in endangered level, in the vulnerable situations. So like that, so much of the vegetation also we are being lost with the climate change. Increasing the pollution level, increasing the sea levels, that all cause for the so much of the damage. Next, please. The you know, the before that, please. Okay. You know, the biggest threats to the, our biodiversity is mainly climate change. How we are changing our climate. Instead of natural climate, we are making an artificial climate. Changes in the land use levels, what are there? Over-exploitation of the species and invasive species and diseases and pollution. These all are causing the big loss. Next, there is so much of the integrated change in the biodiversity assessment, how the climate change is causing effect on the biodiversity. Next, please. What are the main causes of the biodiversity loss? You know, our habitat destruction, global warming, over-exploitation, and pollution, and accident, whatever the precautions, and the non-native species. Because of the non-native species, so much of the highly valuable rich biota we lost. We don't know. Now we are not studying the natural sciences. We are going the technology, biotechnology, something. Without knowing the plant, they are doing the research, they are publishing the paper. But they don't know the value of the nature, value of the plant, value of that nature, value of the biota. If they know, they give the importance. They easily automatically stop the BTs. Okay, and next, please. There is so much of the threats. So many threats are there. We already discussed threats to the biodiversity that are causing climate change, habitat loss, pollution, invasive species, over-exploitation of the natural resources, other potential threats. Some of the insects that are causing totally loss to the biodiversity. Next, please. Next, please, sir. Sir, please, next slide, please. Our global diversity, you know, the steep in the decline. Go back, please. Sir, any instruction to stop up? Please go back, please. Okay. Now, WWF, madam said, as per report, a steep decline is going on. It is warning us, warning flagship to us. Sir, next slide, please. Next to this. Okay. Warning flagship, you know, the 68% loss in between the, these 30 years, just 20 years, 50 years. You know, already Tulsirao sir said 75% of the earth ice pre-land surface already been significantly altered. You know that more than 85% of the area of the wetland has been lost. You see here how it is. They are losing agriculture and patterns. These all are getting affected with this. How they are damaging, how much percentage of the each biota is losing agriculture level and aquaculture level, and so much of the that are causing the destruction. Next, please. You know, already I told you the invasive species that is causing so much of the loss of the biodiversity. You know, nearly 40% of the animal extinction is caused because of the invasive species. I think because of the Alstonia, all the young generation software people will become unfertile by inhale that smell at the night time. Our population also will decrease, no problem. We may not dominate the China because of this invasive species, because of the climate change, because of the unwanted changes in the environment. So many biotas that are entering into our natural bio sources, environment, that is damaging our natural native species. Next, please, sir. You know, the so much of the threats are there. Before that, please. So much of the threats before that slide, please. Okay. You know, there's so many threats are there to the biodiversity. I already discussed urbanization, deforestation, agriculture expansion, eutrophication. Eutrophications are growing up the algal biota that cause the loss of the oxygen to the aquatic biota. And forest fires, now you know the Amazon forest fire, so many forest fires are being happen. That caused so much of the loss of the biodiversity. So many microbes, so many herbs and shrubs along with the trees are being vanished from the world, from the universe. So many are being lost. You know, the exploitation of the water resources, almost all the water resources are contaminated, no problem. There is no, even 1-5% also we can't get the fresh water. You know, the waste disposals, as highly technology, highly educated people, we are damaging highly with our waste, plastic waste. As you know, because of the plastic pollution, our oceanic biota is being damaged. Totally, totally vanished. Overgrazing, poaching. Next, please, sir. Beyond the loss of biodiversity levels, how it is, if you do like this, in the next decade, next century, how it is the percentage, we may lose so much of the diversity. Next, please, sir. You're having so many acts, I already told you, Indian acts related to environment and biodiversity. I already discussed you, Fisheries Act, Indian Forest Act, Mining and Mineral Development Act, Prevention, Air Pollution and Prevention Act, Environmental Protection Act, Biological Diversity Act, Scheduled Tribes and Traditional Forest Acts, so many are there. And policies related to, policies also is there, National Forest Policy, National Conservation Strategy, and Policy Statement and Environment and Development of Policy. Like that, so many policies, National Biodiversity Action Plan, National Agriculture Policy, National Water Policy, National Environmental Policy, these all there. If we follow strictly, if we will be preserve, we can conserve our nature. Next, please, sir. The legislations also are there. Next, please, sir. Next slide. And so many legislations also, their acts are there to conserve, to follow, to preserve our nature, to maintain the ecological balance, to maintain the sustainability. Next, please, sir. Riyasanti antarikshan shanti priddhi shantir apashantir asu odaya vanaspataha shanti vishwadeha shanti brahma shanti sarva shanti santi deva shanti ha shama shanti re. That is a sloka in Ajurveda. That time on we said, now also we have to follow this sloka. We have to follow all the modern people, technology people, new generation people have to follow this. Let them be balanced in the space. Let there be balance in the sky. Let there be peace on the earth. Let there be calmness. Let there be growth in the plant. Let there be growth in the tree. Let there be grace in the gods. Let there be bliss in the Brahma. Let there be balance in everything. Let there be peace, peace, peace. Let such peace be with every one of us, so that we, the masters, we, the leaders, we become the earth leaders, we become the world leaders, if we follow our world ancient sage, this one, developed countries also have to follow these sloka. With that only, we will be free from the pollution, we will be free from the climate change, we can minimize, we can reduce the levels of the pollution, we can maintain the climate without damaging, we can survive with healthy and wealthy, we will be give the more valuable health and climate environment for the future generations by following the sustainable development, by following the nature, by following our tradition, culture, ancient people. We will do the more level best than all the discussions going on in the world. I think all the people, let them know this Shanti Mantra. Let the, I pray God to all the world people have to follow this to maintain the climate evergreen, healthy. Thank you, sir. Thank you for giving this opportunity. Sorry for the inconvenience. Sorry for the late. Sorry for the more and more. Okay, sir. Stop it, sir. We can stop it with this. Okay, sir. Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
Sir, thank you very much for giving time. You bear with me